Now let's just recall all the parameters which we have mentioned so far in order to assess the performance of a transistor amplifier. To discuss the performance of a transistor amplifier, let's recall the different quantities which we have so far discussed. The first quantity is the input resistance, and we know that input resistance is the ratio of the change in input voltage to change in input current, that is delta VBE divided by delta IB, that is change in base emitter, ratio of change in base emitter voltage to the change in base current is called input resistance of a transistor amplifier, whose value usually lies between 100 ohm to 1 kilo ohm is the practical way. When we are checking the transistor, we will connect the base emitter junction to an ohm meter, and if it reads between 100 ohm to 1 kilo ohm, we can say that the transistor base emitter junction is perfect or it is good. If otherwise, we can say that the base emitter junction is destroyed. Then the second parameter, definitely the first one is the input resistance, the second one will be the output resistance. The output resistance can be defined as the ratio of change in collector emitter voltage to the change in collector current. So delta VCE divided by delta IC, which is the color output resistance is very high. It usually is greater than 100 kilo ohm. So to check this collector emitter junction, we will connect the collector base junction to the ohm meter. Remember that here we are connecting the collector base because it is the reverse biased terminal. So collect, to check the whether a transistor is good or not, we will connect the collector base terminal of the transistor to an ohm meter, and if it reads greater than 100 kilo ohms or very high value, we can say that the transistor second PN junction, that is collector base junction, or the collector diode is okay. But remember that the output resistance of this amplifier circuit is the collector ratio of the change in collector emitter voltage to the collector current. Now the third parameter is the effective collector load. The reason for taking the effective collector load is that we know that the output resistance is very high, and also it is connected to collector resistance in the collector circuit. So the effective load will be the combination of this output resistance as well as the load resistance or the collector resistance connected in the circuit. So there are, from the diagram we can see that the output resistance and the collector resistance are connected in parallel. So the effective collector load is usually denoted by RIC is equal to the RC parallel to the output resistance R0. So you know that the combination, if they are parallel, it will be RC into R0 divided by RC plus R0. Usually the collector resistance, the value of the collector resistance which is to be connected in the collector circuit is few kilo ohms in usually common emitter transistor amplifier. For our practical purposes, we will connect it is around 1.2 kilo ohm, but R0 we know that it comes around 100 kilo ohm. So usually this RC is less than R0. If you substitute it here, we can say that RAC is approximately, that is the effective collector load is approximately equal to the collector resistance RC itself. If you substitute it here, you can see that denominator will be approximately R0. The R0 and R0 will cancel. What remains is RC. So that is the effective collector load. Now if we are having multi-stage amplifiers, then the effective collector resistance will be, we will have the RAC as the effective collector load of the first stage, and the second stage will have a input resistance, let's call it as RI. Then RAC parallel to RI will be the output resistance of our effective collector load of a multi-stage amplifier. If we are having a two-stage amplifier, the effective collector load of the first stage will be RAC parallel to RI. The second stage definitely will be approximately equal to the RC2, that is the collector resistance connected in the second stage. Those will be more familiar when we are doing with the amplifier circuits, single stage amplifiers and multi-stage amplifiers. Just remember that transistor amplifier circuit, the effective collector load will be the parallel combination of the collector resistance and the output resistance. If we are using the multi-stages, then in between the stages we will have effective collector load as the parallel combination of this collector resistance, the output resistance of the first stage and input resistance of the second stage, and their parallel combination. So now the another parameter which is of importance while considering an amplifier circuit is the current gain, because common emitter transistor connection is used because it provides very good current, voltage and power gain. So these three factors are the, or parameters are the next three important parameter in the case of an amplifier circuit. The current gain is defined as the ratio of the output current to the ratio of the change in output current to the change in input current. So we can write it as current gain in the case of a common emitter transistor amplifier is beta is equal to delta IC by delta IB. And this value beta usually ranges from 20 to 500. That depends upon the transistor. Then the next one is the voltage gain. Voltage gain, again denoted by AV, voltage gain. This is equal to the ratio of the output voltage to the input voltage, that is delta VCE divided by delta VBE. The ratio of the change in output voltage to the change in input voltage. So it can be written as delta voltage is the current into resistance, so output current is the delta IC into the output resistance is the effective collector load RAC divided by delta VB, that is a change in input voltage is the change in input current, that is delta IB into the, let's call it as RI, the input resistance. Previously we have denoted by small letter RI, that represents the when AC signal is applied. Here it is for pure DC. Whatever the notation, that doesn't matter. So let's come to this one. Delta IC by delta IB is beta. So we will have a beta RAC divided by RI as the voltage gain. Remember that the voltage gain is practically, we can call it as V0 by VI, output voltage by input voltage. In the case of a common emitter transistor amplifier, output voltage is collector emitter voltage, input voltage is the base emitter voltage. So in terms of the current amplification factor, we can write it as beta is equal to RAC divided by RI, where RAC is the effective collector load, and that is the effective output resistance of the amplifier, and RI is the input resistance of the amplifier. Now the last parameter which we should remember in the case of a transistor amplifier is the power gain. Power gain, usually denoted by the letter AP, represents the gain, and it is AP which is equal to, you can directly write it as the ratio of the change in output power divided by, or output power to input power, ratio of output power to input power, or output power divided by input power will give you the power gain. That I can write like this: delta I in terms of the current, delta IC square, I square or AC divided by delta IB square into RI. So this can be written as delta IC divided by delta IB into delta IC into RAC divided by delta IB into the RI. Now delta IC by delta IB is nothing but beta, or the current gain into delta IC RAC divided by delta IB RI is nothing but the voltage gain. So power gain is obtained by the product of current gain and voltage gain. So that's all about the basics of a transistor when it is used as an amplifier. Remember that in order to use a transistor as an amplifier, it should be in the active region. That means the base emitter junction should be forward bias, that is emitter diode should be forward bias. For that we should have a proper bias voltage in the circuit. And the collector base junction should be reverse bias, so for that we will have a voltage source VCC connected in the collector circuit. And if the transistor is not in the active region, it cannot be used as an amplifier. But when it is in the saturated region or cutoff, we can use this transistor as a switch in the case of in cutoff and saturation regions. Thank you.